So I had no intention of watching or reviewing The Tick this weekend, but I ended up binge-watching the entire thing last night, so let's talk about it. So The Tick follows Arthur, a mild-mannered, nervous, and mentally unstable young man who believes that there's a guy out there called the Terror who's running the underworld of the city, even though the Terror is supposedly dead. Along the way, someone called the Tick, a very stupid but very powerful superhero that doesn't know where he comes from, shows up to help him on his adventure, even though Arthur does not want to be on this adventure, and thus you get a very weird and wacky and fun kind of spoof of the superhero genre along the way. So this is based off of an 80s comic book, as well as that it was a 90s cartoon that I grew up with. It came out right at, I was the right age that it was targeting me when the 90s Tick cartoon came out. So I don't know that I've seen every episode, but I might have seen every single episode of it. I never watched the previous live action show. That's kind of my experience with the Tick. Big fan of the 90s cartoon. Never read any of the comics. Did not see the previous live action. That's my experience going into this one. And I for whatever reason, I just wasn't particularly interested. I didn't even watch a trailer for it. I didn't watch the pilot when it came out a year ago. And just because I saw some Facebook status updates from people saying it was actually good, I was like, I guess I'll give it a shot. Clicked go on it, watched the entire thing. So let's talk about the good on this one. Right off the bat, it just has a nice, fun tone to it. It's like they nailed what they were going for. It doesn't feel like it goes too wacky. It doesn't feel too serious. It's definitely grown up. It's not aimed for kids. It's not an adaptation of the 90s cartoon. It's the more violent version of the Tick character. There's some of the characters are vigilantes that blow people's heads off and slit throats and stuff like that. So it gets violent. There's a good bit of language in this as well. And they seem to hit kind of that tone that they're going for, that it feels like they're hitting just the right spot for the nature of what this show is supposed to be. And then next thing you got to talk about is the casting here. I was a little bit nervous about the guy they cast as the Tick. Peter Serafinowicz, I don't know how to pronounce his name. He's one of these guys you've seen in a lot of stuff. He's in Guardians of the Galaxy. He's been in a number of TV shows over the years. He's actually the voice of Darth Maul. And I didn't actually realize it was him until I started watching the show. He just looked off to me from all the promo shots I saw. But as soon as I was watching it, I mean, he nails kind of the big bravado and the speeches and the eloquent, nonsensical statements of the Tick very nicely. And so it just kind of fits perfectly into the role he's supposed to be playing. He's also 6'5". And so while at first glance you don't immediately think of him as this big, imposing guy, as soon as you see him standing next to other people, he's a gigantic human being, especially next to the guy playing Arthur, who's like 5'6". So you see him next to each other, and my mom was like, Is that guy really tall, or is the other guy really short? And the answer is yes to both of those questions. So the casting on it, just the people they were able to get to the different roles, even like the Terror is played by Jackie Earle Haley in a role totally different from what he normally plays. And you normally see him as like the creepy bad guy. He's the campy, flamboyant bad guy. So a nice change of pace there. There was a voice in it that's from Alan Tudyk that I wasn't expecting. I was like, that can't be Alan Tudyk, but it's just as good as him and it sounds like him. It was him. So just the casting all around, really nice. And for the most part, people you don't know or lesser known people, just all doing a really nice job in their roles. But overall, it's just a nice, fun show. It's not aiming to be the biggest thing, the best thing. It's not trying to blow your mind. It's just like, hey, in the modern era of superhero movies just dominating the theaters, this is the right time for The Tick, this type of spoof of the superhero genre. Let's just do a fun version of it for an older audience. And that's what this is. Now, moving on to the bad, I don't necessarily have any big negatives on it. Just so much that I wasn't laughing out loud as much as I necessarily wanted to. It wasn't something that had big, gigantic wow moments. It was just solid entertainment. And that's kind of the biggest negative I would have about it, is that I'd seen some people like, I love The Tick, and I didn't love it. Now, that's not a criticism. It's not like I can pinpoint exactly what it was. It just didn't knock it out of the park for me. It was just solid entertainment. And I don't have a problem with that. I'm excited for more episodes when they debut next year. And so this was just a solid six episodes that I wasn't even planning on watching, ended up watching all of them in a row, and certainly something that if you watch the trailer, it seems kind of interesting, it's worth checking out. That's what I'd say. I recommend give a thumbs up to The Tick. It's solid entertainment. It's only six episodes, so you can watch it in under 3 hours. That's why I binge watched the whole thing. And so it's worth your time to invest in it. See if you like it. See if it's your thing. I know I liked it. How about you? Tell me your thoughts about it down below in the comment section. I'd love to hear your take on it. Have you seen the 90s cartoon? Did you see the live action? Have you happened to read the comic books? How does it compare to all of that? I'd love to hear your thoughts on it. If you're new to my channel, please consider clicking that subscribe button. I do movie reviews, TV reviews from time to time, like the one you're watching right now, as well as ranking videos. I'll have a new one of those up coming up in just a few hours. If you're watching this right when I post this. But with all that said, thank you for watching.